Welcome back to Good Morning LaLa. On Wealth Wednesday, the most important thing we have is our mental health, for sure. And we have two extraordinary women in the house. We have Dawn Fields and Micky Levy. They're all about her mind in pieces. This is, tell us a little bit about what that is exactly.
It's an anthology of short stories that is made by women about women struggling with various mental illnesses. Mm. And we like to call it Breaking Down, Breaking Through, Breaking Free.
So what was the motivation for this?
Well, I have a short film in the anthology, and when we were on the festival circuit with it, it just raised so much awareness about the mental health issue that it's about, and opened so many discussions and conversations that I wanted to reach a larger audience. And you know, short films are kind of limited in what you can do with just them. So I'm like, let me try to find some other shorts that are equally powerful that raise awareness about mental health and put it together and get it out there as a feature so we have more places we can show it.
Right. Love it. So what was it about these 9 short films that inspired you to choose them to be included in part of the anthology?
Well, it's funny because when I first started, I didn't intend on it being all about women by women, but I started the call for submissions with a female group of filmmakers that I belong to. I got 150 films sent in.
Wow.
And they were all by women, about women. They weren't about men. It was women trying to tell stories in their own creative expression, the filmmakers in their own creative expressionist way about the topic. And they're all treated very differently.
We all have some stories about some mental illness.
Yeah, right. We've all experienced that storm.
Right.
If you will.
The storm,
which brings us to the title, Fragile Storm.
Fragile Storm is the name of my short. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that one is because it starts out on this rainy, scary night and you think, there's this older man keeping this young girl hostage, but then in the end you realize it's completely something else, which has to do with her altered state and her altered reality.
Fantastic. Wow. Tell us a little bit about your short.
My short is about a young woman who doesn't want to be who she is. She's exceedingly gifted, but all she can see are her own shortcomings. So it's really, although it deals with mental, excuse me, although it deals with mental health, it does so in a way, it falls into the sci-fi genre. So I love experimenting with genre and stories that have meaning, but are also fun to watch.
Yes. I think it's also important to include the conversation around the caregiver and the caretaker,
yes,
of the people who are experiencing the mental illness and the effect it has on them.
Yeah, that was my story, Fragile Storm, because I think we often hear stories and see stories about the people suffering, but not so much about the people caring for them.
Mm.
And they have their own hardships, their own struggles. I like to say their own horrors, because mm-hmm. our film kind of starts out like a horror film and then you realize what's really going on. So it's really the horror that the caregiver can go through sometimes when things get rough and they get hard and you lose control.
Right.
Mm. And you don't know what to do.
So what do you feel like the big takeaway is, you know, as, you know, dealing with mental stuff, where we deal with a lot, positive psychologists, Dr. Divinity, we're all in this conversation about, you know, how to overcome the mind, how to really master the mind. And we know that we're collectively connected. And I think a lot of times, a lot of my clients they'll have kind of times when they don't feel so well mentally. Mm. And sometimes it's just that they're tapping into something going on the astrological plane, sometimes that they're tapping into the collective consciousness. What do you think your guys' takeaway is with it when it comes to, like, how do you deal with mental health?
Well, first and foremost, as I was saying about my morning routine, for me, it's a lot of bad foods actually affect my mood and my emotions. And so I try to be very careful to avoid those things that I notice drain my energy, make me feel bad, make me kind of emotionally unlevel, you know, or like kind of all over the map, you know? And I've had great success with the plant-based diet doing that.
Good.
You know, everybody's different and what works for them, but for me, diet.
Yeah, they say the second mind is the gut, and if the gut's not well, you'll be a little cuckoo.
Yeah, yep. No, I had bad brain fog prior to this, and it just cleared like within a couple weeks.
Hmm. I love meditation. To me, it's if you get yourself quiet and you still yourself, you get clarity.
Mm.
For sure.
I think that's just beautiful. I love that point so much, because it wasn't until I really started, I mean, I had an inkling before I started meditation, but once I started meditation, I began to realize the ways in which I was experiencing all kinds of different forms of mental illness, right? Mm-hmm. They talk about mental illness being on a spectrum, really,
mm-hmm.
and they draw a line somewhere in the sand and they say, this is clinical and diagnosable, and this is not necessarily clinical, but we all experience that spectrum.
Yeah, sure.
Right. And so while the that sort of anthology is about entirely sort of lots of clinical issues, it's also about all of us that are struggling with sort of different forms, mild forms of mental illness in our daily lives.
Yeah, and what's interesting to me is not only what the characters in the films are going through and how they're all different stories, but how the women who created those stories have treated the subject matter. Some of them are fantasy-based, some of them, like mine, are more reality-based, mm-hmm. but they're all compassionate. Mm-hmm. They're all told through a compassionate lens. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what makes the anthology special, and hopefully we'll start some dialogue. Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic. They also say that's what makes therapy special, is the ability to sort of hold this space of unconditional regard.
Yeah.
But that's the most significant transformative element to any therapeutic approach.
Wow. Right? Well, first so you have to address the thing too. You have to acknowledge the problem too, right, before you can seek help. Yeah, like, what sure. is wrong with me? What's mm-hmm. making me feel this way?
For sure. Yeah. So tell people about, it's on Friday, is that correct?
Yeah, Friday Great. Night, 7:30 at the Man Chinese Theater.
You all should
Theater.
Come.
Oh,
yes. 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 The Man Chinese Theater, by the way, if you're not in La La Land, is one of the most iconic
yes.
venues to screen a film.
That's why we chose the film festival.
Congratulations.
Because, yeah, it's a beautiful mm-hmm. venue, iconic, and it's our world premiere. All the filmmakers are coming out. They'll be there for a Q&A afterwards. So it's a unique opportunity to ask those questions and start those dialogues.
We know it's also part of the film festival, right? The Golden State
it's
Film
opening
Festival.
Night. Golden opening State Film night. Festival, yeah.
Congratulations.
That's great. Yeah, so where can people get tickets and find more information?
They can just go to hermindofpieces.com. We have a link there straight to the ticket purchase for that and all of our upcoming screenings. So you can get on our mailing list, and we'll tell you the different cities we're screening in after LA. And also, hopefully, we'll go to VOD at some point, Netflix, Amazon, something like that, Great. So it can reach a wider audience.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having us.
So much.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.